Hello everyone, you welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I want to share with you how to control oil production on your face. Now, personally, I produce a lot of oil and I've got to get questions like, my face is always shiny, my face is always oily. How can I control this? Now, excess sebum production is what most people suffer, but knowing exactly what to do is just what will help you. And I am here today to help you put your oil under control. That's why I'm making this video. Unfortunately, most people try to do a lot of things to put their oil under control, but yet they tend to produce more oil instead of putting the oil under control. So if you are in that position, please do not worry. Just sit back and I'll be taking you through how to put your oil under control. But before we go right there, you're welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time stopping by, thank you very much for stopping by. If you've always been there, oh, it gladdens my heart. Thank you for always being there. So before we go right there into the video again, please, if you're yet to subscribe to my channel and hit on the notification bell. That way you'll be notified whenever we upload new videos on the Pretty Hat TV. So I'm going to be sharing with you some things I've tried and some I have not tried, but these will work for you. So the first I want to share with you is that if you have shiny face and you want to put it under control, you might want to consider using clay mask. Now, when you use clay masks that contain certain ingredients like smectite, bentonite, and kaolin clay, these will help put your oil really under control because they absorb oil really well, controls the skin shine. So the next you want to consider doing is to not skip your moisturizer, right? So people whose face tend to produce more oil have this belief that using moisturizers on their face will help their face produce excess oil, right? That's a misconception. You don't want to skip your moisturizer because your face produces much oil, right? Rather, you want to not skip your moisturizer. What that does for you is that it helps put your oil production under control. Now, when you skip your moisturizer, what your face is going to do, it's going to overproduce oil, right? Because it doesn't want your face to be dry. So your face is going to overproduce oil and that will not be good for you, right? But when you use your moisturizer, it's going to really put your oil production under minimal control. You want to hydrate. Now, there are certain things that you can use to hydrate: your hyaluronic acid, glycerin, snail oils. These are the things that will help you hydrate your skin, right? So when your skin is hydrated, it helps put your oil production under control. And you want to avoid astringent toners that will help strip your skin of its necessary oil that will make your skin really, really look dry, right? So rather, you want to use what we hydrate your skin, please. So hydrate your skin. That will help put your oil production under control. You want to incorporate certain ingredients like zinc, niacinamide, and retinols in your skincare routine. What this does is that it helps reduce, regulate, and controls the production of oil to an extent. What you want to do is to use like serums that contains oil or some of these ingredients. In fact, most times they are standalone ingredients. Sometimes it can contain zinc and niacinamide. Then retinol is a standalone serum, right? So you would want to try incorporating these in your skincare routine. Now, I've made videos on how you can incorporate some of these ingredients. You might want to check that out in my previous videos. Another thing you would want to try out is blotting papers. Now, blotting papers can be used to control your oil on the go, right? So when you're going out, you can go out with your blotting papers, and when you notice that you're producing oils, they can help you take off oil when you place them on the oil producing area, maybe on your T-zone area, your forehead, or wherever you produce oil. You just put them on that area. It will help extract the excess oil without destroying your makeup, right? Without leaving your makeup messy, right? So you can use your blotting papers whether you have your makeup on or not. I recommend clean and clear absorbing sheets. Now this helps take oil off your face like quickly and remove shine from your face, right? So you can do well to get that, or just get any absorbing sheet that can help do this work, right, without leaving your face or your makeup messy. Translucent powder, like mattifying powder, right? This will help really put your oil production under control. It helps suck excess oil from your face. It removes excess shine, and it just overall helps put your oil production under control. So what you want to do is to go for the one with SPF. Right, they are translucent. They are translucent powder with SPF. So you might want to consider using the one with SPF. Now, I would want to know how you put your oil under control. Do you have challenge putting your oil under control? Let us know all of that in the comment section below. So I just thought I should share this with you because this is what a lot of people really go through. And I personally, I have a very, very oily face, but thank God I've been able to put my oil under control with the power of knowledge, right? So before you go, just give this video a thumb up if it was helpful to you, and I'll see you guys in my next video. As I come your way again, always remember to stay pretty, because everything is pretty. See you guys in my next video. Bye.